everyone, I'm Ms. Taniya Sutradhar and today we will focus on the writing step. Do you know students that every picture tells a story? Yes, it does. Whether it's the picture on the cover of a book or this very painting hanging on the wall behind me. Now, today we are going to do picture composition, where we are going to learn how to frame few meaningful sentences on a given picture or set of pictures. But for this, we need to keep few points in mind, as these points will help us to frame sentences very easily. So let's try to frame 5 sentences on this given picture. Now, remember, our first step is to observe the picture very carefully. So observe this picture. Now our second step is to prepare a set of questions based on our observation of the picture. So let's try to frame 5 sentences on this picture. Since we are going to frame 5 sentences, so I have prepared 5 questions based on my observation. Now our first question is, what is the setting? Our next question should be, what is happening in the picture? Third is, what can you see in the picture? Well, I can see so many players here. So, the question is, how many players are there? Our next question is, what is the main action that is going on in the picture? What is everybody focusing on? Well, as you can see in the picture, everybody is focusing on the batsman. So what is the batsman doing? And the next question is, what can you see in the background? Now, our next step is that after we have set the questions, to note down the answer of these questions and write them as points in a logical manner. So let's try to answer these questions. Let's look at the first question. What is the setting? Well, this is a picture of a cricket stadium. Let's look at the second question. What is happening in the picture? Well, a cricket match is going on. Our third question is, how many players are there? So let's see how many players can we see in the picture. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can say that there are 5 players in the picture. Our fourth question is, what is the batsman doing? Look at the batsman. So we can say that the batsman is trying to hit the ball to score runs. Our fifth question is, what can you see in the background? We can see the crowd. So we can say that the crowd is cheering for the players. Also note that crowd is your collective noun. And as you all know that the collective noun is always in singular form. That's why we have used the helping verb is. You can also talk about the emotions of the characters in the picture. Like, the batsman seems stressed. The crowd is enjoying the match. Or the players are having fun. Isn't it easy to frame 5 sentences on a given picture? Now why stick to this picture? Let's look at this very scenario and try to frame 5 sentences on it. Like the way I taught you. Start with the setting. This is a living room. What is happening here? A teacher is teaching. What else can you see here? Well, there's a sofa and a table here. What is there in the background? A beautiful painting is hanging on the wall. Let's talk about the emotion of the character. Who's the character here? The teacher. How is the teacher feeling? The teacher is feeling happy to teach. She is having fun while teaching. Now, let's quickly recapitulate what we have learned through this video.
picture composition. At the end of this lesson, you will be able to write several sentences on a given topic after looking at a picture related to it. Write a paragraph or story based on the observations of the given picture.
Hi friends! Have you heard the quote, "Every picture tells a story"? That is exactly what we are going to learn. We are going to write stories looking at some pictures. Writing stories in this manner is a lot of fun. So, let's begin. Here's the first picture on which I'm going to write a few sentences. And here I have three pictures. I need to write a composition on these pictures. I can't wait to get started writing my story. Do you want to join me in learning how to write a picture composition? Come along!
Let us begin writing sentences on the first picture in Zizi's book. We can see there are many elements in this picture. To understand the picture in detail, let us first prepare a question-answer list. What is happening in the picture? The children are celebrating a birthday party. Whose birthday party is it? It's Kyra's birthday party. Kyra is the name of a girl. How many candles are there on the cake? There are 5 candles on the cake. What is the magician doing? The magician is pulling out a rabbit from his hat. What is the clown doing? The clown is giving the balloons to the children. How many gifts are seen on the table? There are 3 gifts on the table. These questions and answers help us describe the picture in detail. Based on these points, we can now write a composition of around 7 to 8 sentences. Let us begin by giving a title to our composition. We can give it the title, Kyra's Birthday Party. Begin with the first sentence a little away from the margin. Kyra is celebrating her birthday. She is cutting a pink strawberry cake. There are 5 candles on the cake. Kyra's friends are seated next to her. They are watching a magician remove a rabbit from his hat. A clown is giving balloons to the children. There are 3 birthday gifts on the table. The children are having lots of fun at Kyra's birthday party. That was easy, wasn't it?
Now that you know what a picture composition is, I'm going to assign you a task where you can draw any picture. It can be a picture of a scenery, or a picture of your bedroom, or a picture of you playing with your siblings, or a family picture. Make the picture look attractive and write at least 5 sentences on it. Thank you.